10 minutes ago, it was almost too quiet in this building, but the pent-up energy and nerves have been released. Here are the starting goalies for Game 7 in this epic Western Canadian battle. Mika Kiprusoff gets his first Game 7 assignment. Alex Auld's first ever playoff win was Saturday's triple overtime thriller, and he gets a Game 7 start for an encore. Dan Marinelli in charge tonight along with Brad Watson, your linesman Mark Wheeler, and Brad Kovacic. Calgary has lost three straight seventh games. Vancouver split a pair a year ago.
Calgary has to weather the storm here. Vancouver wants to create a forecheck immediately.
Trevor Linden, Stefan Yell, and away we go. Ed Jovanovski up ahead to Linden, bumped off the puck. Flames starting Marcus Nilsson, Chris Clark, and Yell. Rachinski over the line, works in, centers. And it will go to the Flames. Marty Rachinski opened the scoring in Game 7 last year here in the first round as a member of the St. Louis Blues. Trevor Linden back to get the puck in his own zone. Malik dropped his stick in front of the net, and Alex Auld tries to tuck it into the net. That could be dangerous as the blade is still in the goal mouth. Here's Brad May, who scored in Game 6. May flips it into Calgary ice. Now taken to the boards is Robin Regier on his 24th birthday. Regier serenaded in the dressing room this morning by his teammates after being the busiest man in Game 6 with 43 minutes and 21 seconds of ice time. Now Auld out to sweep that puck to the far boards. Marty Jelinek nailed. He's on the ice with Jerome Iginla in behind the net, trying to come out in front. Iginla swivels, but Bert Sokol stays with him. Now Conroy's on the puck. He'll fire it around. Jelinek gives chase on the other side. Ferentz pinching in. It's Iginla behind the net. A centering pass. Now Lombardi off the pinch. And his shot is handled by Auld. And Calgary exerting the first pressure 90 seconds into Game 7. Matt Lombardi gets it to the captain. They're still changing as Iginla swept it in front. Chubarov lost his footing and Niemann centered it across. And finally, Mike Keane will get a chance to tap it out. Canucks on a change. Calgary trying to burn them. Lombardi with the shot. And that goes wide. Now Donovan, the last man off the bench on this good Calgary change, goes after it. Cook with a bump, but it stays in. Robin Regier plays it wide. And the Flames going to the attack, undaunted by an overtime loss in Game 6. Regier sending it to the near side. Sokol with the backhand. Maslin trying to get out. Unsuccessful. Leopold holds the zone. And now it's Sokol trying again. And finally, it's out at center ice. And Cook plays it into the Calgary zone. What a first couple of shifts for the Flames. Here's Sokol. Check that Sallow playing it ahead. He is tagged by Sabrykin out with Marcus Nilsson. Across it goes Commodore. Quick shot right on rebound. Komisu played it wide of the net. And now Morrison, the man who ended Game 6 ahead for Naslin. They both scored in the seventh game against St. Louis a year ago. Trevor Linden back out, and the puck is called offside at the Calgary line as Jovanovski was unable to hold the zone.
Tremendous pressure to start off this game for the Calgary Flames. They really believe that they can spin off the defense down low and walk from behind the net or find late players, and a couple of big saves for Alex Auld here early. But this is the area behind the net and in the corners that they think they can win battles. And Calgary wins a battle here, and here's another chance, a wraparound attempt. And Alex Auld looks very sharp so far early in this game.
Just shy of 3 minutes in. Three shots for the Flames so far. Vancouver, there's their first from Mattias Olund, who opened the scoring for the Canucks in Game 7 against Minnesota.
And Kiprusoff there a little deep in his net to start off the hockey game. And one area where David Marcoux, the goalie coach, wants him to work on is to be alert all the time. He felt that he lost his focus, particularly on the Brad May goal in Game 6, when things weren't going well for Kiprusoff in that game.
Four goals on six shots in the middle of Game 6 before Kiprusoff got it back Here's Henrik Sedin. Daniel fires, and that was blocked as Rhett Warner got in the way. Now Aginla rolling it in, and Marty Zielinek has had the first two shifts along with the captain and Craig Conroy. Henrik Sedin pulled down, puck played ahead, and off goes Linden with Daniel Sedin. So Trevor Linden starts up front with the Sedins. Seemed to split his assignments in game six between that line and other duties. Zielinek sends it in off Jovanovski. Chris Clark is after it. Clark with a goal and an assist. Two nights ago, Jarkko Ruutu had a goal for Vancouver. In fact, four Canuck goals scored by first-time goal scorers in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Now it's Sanderson, another, who scored in game six for the first time. Up to Chubarov, over two lines. Offside called against Vancouver.
Well, of course, Denis Gauthier out in this game, hurting his name, and Rhett Warner just blocked the shot moments ago and hit him in the thigh. And we'll have a look at it here. As Sedin passes it back, here's the shot. And Warner was a little tender going over to the player's bench. He seems to be okay. And of course, Steve Bonador gets his first action for the Calgary Flames. He's a right-handed shot that's going to have to play in the left side, which will make it even tougher for this kid in his first action of this year's National Hockey League playoff.
Warner, one of three Calgary defensemen over 40 minutes in game six. The other two, Regier and Leopold, are on the ice right now. Bouncing puck. Knocked away from Cook as he charged in, looking for the garbage, and then he knocks over Donovan. A rink-wide feed up to Sean Donovan, and the Timmins native in with a shot handled by another Northern Ontario boy, Alex Hull.
Well, it was quite a night in game six. And as you can see, the Calgary Flames defense without Denis Gauthier had to be busy, and I mean busy. Regier, Leopold, Warner, Ferentz, all close to or over 40 minutes. Matthias Olin, Jovanovski, the same. Matthias Olin, who went head-to-head, of course, with Aginla, was at 65 times. He went back and forth to the bench. 65 shifts in that game. Imagine, I get tired thinking about it.
Tired jumping over the boards. And Olin was exhausted at night's end, but he held Aginla to two shots. Here's one, and it's steered away by Olin. Good chance for Jerome Aginla from the high slot. Now he'll walk up with Olin again in the corner. Saprykin's on the line now. Conroy to Saprykin, and he whipped it across the goal mouth. It will be kept in by Warner. And again, the Flames exerting the pressure. Saprykin behind the net, trying to work his way, and Olin slows him up. Support from Conroy, now cleared out, and Warner has to scramble back. He'll play it in, and a delayed offside. The Flames will make changes. Canucks also send out fresh forwards. Straczynski's on the ice. Andrew Ferentz just shy of 40 minutes in game six. There's Mike Commodore. And now Chris Clark looks rink-wide. Marcus Wilson beaten to the puck by Jovanovski. Following in, Stefan Jell. But as you can see, Nielsen trapped offside.
One of the challenges for Mark Crawford, he's got a bunch of left-hand shots. They're playing on the offside because most of his wingers are left-hand shots. And Jeff Sanderson had a heck of a time on that. Here he is on his wing. He gets caught way too down low, and that creates the point shot. But again, look at the front of the net. And Canucks are having trouble when the Flames forwards are beating him from the front of the net. And there's Sanderson again on the half boards. And I talked to him about it, and the coaches have talked to him about it. And it's a very difficult assignment for offside wingers when they're getting pressure to play on their offside.
Morrison, Naslin, Cook back out for the Canucks as Malik will chase this down in the Vancouver zone, and icing against Calgary.
Sanderson said, you know, I was quite aware of what happened in game six, and I've watched tape, and I'm going to try to adjust to be a little tighter to the points. But it's not just him. In front of the net, Vancouver has to be aware of the way the forwards, Calgary, are beating Vancouver's defense in front of the net. That's why the tips were so available for Calgary in game six.
Face-off won by Jell against Morrison. He has had a good series in the face-off circle. He's bowled over by Jell there. And apparently the officials going to let them play at the outset of game seven. Leopold and Cook. And now Regier on the far side. Jovanovski stepped up, took the hit, held the zone. Centering pass gobbled up by Leopold. Up ahead, Jell without a stick, reaching for the puck. It'll be kept in by Vancouver. And now Cook working for it. Regeer up the boards. Yell still with a cue in his hand and now is able to bat it out across the line. Haslam fishing for it, and Morris plays it back. Jovanovski on the right side, and Mike Keane will dig after it. 10th game, 7 for the veteran Keane, and he got a piece of Regeer. He's got the puck now, and a shot off target. Billy Niemann flipping it ahead. Salo knocks it down. Donovan there for Calgary, and the Flames can't get it. Well, they do get it. Pass Salo, who knocked it out of midair, back in. Offside. CBC's Hockey Night in Canada returns in a moment.
There's no question, it's pretty obvious, particularly on Vancouver's last shift, that they are trying to hit the Calgary Flame defensemen. They know that they played a lot in Game 6, and they're tired right now. So they're trying to get right after them.
They just had a look at Steve Monador, the freshest of the Calgary Blue Liners, in his first game of the series, and what a spot to be in.
Watching a lot of line-for-line work early. Trevor Linden out at the moment against Lombardi. And, of course, Matthias Olin will continue to play against Ginla. But look for Ginla in this game to be double-shifted a lot to get away from Olin.
Well, the Sedins have been strong the last two games. Here's a shot from the point. Knocked down in front. And away goes Billy Niemann, who almost ended the series in overtime when he beat Olin but hit the crossbar. And now he hits Allen. And we're going to get the first penalty of the game, and it will be Billy Niemann.
Niemann doesn't like this call, and he may have a case. The question is, did Salo duck or not when contact was about to be made? Sutter thinks so. Let's have a look. Well, that's close. That's close. Check that, it's Allen. And did he duck or not? And Niemann jumped, and that's the thing that perhaps caused the penalty. As soon as he left his feet, he's in the penalty box. That's a good call. Boarding will be the call.
Boarding is the call. Four times Niemann's been in the box, and the Canucks have converted on the power play in this series. 8 Vancouver power play goals. They were 1-for-5 in Game 6. And again, half their power play goals with number 24 sitting in the box. Here they go. Regeer fires around the boards. Yep. Hit Rychinski, and he's shaken up.
Right in the ear.
Not in the ear. Jovanovski, Rychinski to the bench. Daniel Sedin checks in, and a shot deflecting over the net. And Morrison looks for it. It's knocked away. Now Conroy a chance to clear, and he'll get it past Sokol down the ice.
One thing the Flames talked about in their meeting this morning, they had 4 penalties in the first period. They got to stay out of the penalty box if they expect to win this game.
Daniel Sedin had a power play goal in the last game, and it was a beauty. Jovanovski unable to hold it in. He'll play it back to Alex Auld, and he'll send it over on the left side to Brent Sokol. A move to try and shake the check of Yell. Up for Henrik Sedin. Over the line with Sanderson. Henrik Sedin holds on. Sanderson to the front. Back to Olin. Salo, the other point man. Henrik takes a look. And a deflection by Daniel. Handled by Kiprasov. Nice play. Better save. Now Sanderson out of the corner. Back to Salo. And a glove stop by Kiprasov.
Early confidence here for Kiprasov as he makes a tremendous save on Sedin, who redirected the puck from the point shot right in the slot. And there is Henrik Sedin, the Daniel Sedin, and a beautiful blocker save, and he read it well. Rychinski gets one right in the ear, trying to block down the puck that's coming around hard off the glass. And we'll check on him. The ice
pass. His ears are buzzing. Marcus Nielsen off the boards and out. Less than a half minute remaining in the first power play of Game 7. Mark Marcus Nielsen, who leads the National Hockey League Stanley Cup playoffs in power play points with five. Is turning back with Lombardi hounding him. Jovanovski returns it. Now Naslin in with Cook. Morrison in front of Naslin. Pounded there by Nielsen. Sammy Salo tees and fires. Knocked down. Centered. Nielsen clears.
Ooh, that puck was rolling. That was a dangerous shot by Salo that just didn't get through.
Pair of shots on the power play that has elapsed now. Niemann, and nice pass. Aginla shot to the pad stop by Ault. So Jerome Aginla's had a pair of good shots on Ault in the opening 10 minutes.
The goalies are ready.
And Aginla with only two shots in six periods two nights ago.
Both goalies have battled so far in the first 10 minutes in this hockey game. Aginla has that quick release, and he always seems to like this area. Low on the pads. And Alex Ault in terrific position. I mean, he was perfect on that save. Top of the crease, right pad out.
Approaching the midway mark of this first period. And Shubarov is out with Keane and Sanderson. Against Saprykin, Donovan, and Yell. We expect to see variety of combinations from both coaches tonight. Mondor stripped to the puck. Here's Keane working in, sprawling his Yell. Back to Marek-Philippe, and across Sokol. Watched up high by Saprykin. Yell down low defensively. Plays it into the near corner. And Monador, who was born in Vancouver, plays it ahead. Donovan to the attack over the line. Shubarov breaks it up. Now in turn, Nielsen steers it back in. Fires, and that's off Malik. High off the netting. We still await the first goal of Game 7.
If there's no such thing as an average family, why drive an average family SUV? Three German-engineered SUVWs that are anything but average.
Until November 30th, get financing from 0% plus complimentary 3 years maintenance.
Volkswagen.
Kick off the day with protein and energy from Vector. Show the boss who's boss. Show the game who's game. Nice catch. Show up with high protein and energy from Vector.
Well, Vancouver's probably biggest concern tonight is Kiprusoff. Look at this. He always seems to bounce back after allowing four more goals. And Vancouver has to get to Kiprusoff early. And so far this game, they've been getting lots of shots on him. No results yet.
We mentioned it after game one when he allowed five. The teams he bounced back against, some of the top clubs in the NHL. Detroit, Colorado, San Jose, and again Vancouver in game two. Here's Henrik Sedin digging in. Lombardi tying him up. And Niemann, who had another word with the officials about that penalty call, flipping it down the ice. In on all with Tomasu charging in. The BC boy will cause a little traffic on the doorstep.
Now we watch Alex Ault already with a couple of nice pad saves. This is what he does in his morning work just before the shots start. A little shadow boxing, getting positioning all over the ice. And then he'll get into his half splits. We'll see him do this a lot tonight. Pass acrosses, and then this is what's called skating on your knees. You'll go down, push across, skate across, and the butterfly. Look at how big he is, and look at how much of the net he covers, even when he's down.
Offensive face-off controlled by Craig Conroy. Now the Commodore flipping it to the net, and that didn't miss by much with traffic along the way. And big Commodore dashing back into his own zone, gives it to Jelena. Jelena gives it away, and Sokol fires right on. Brent Sokol with four overtime shots the other night. And look out. It's Ruutu in the corner in a scuffle with Marty Jelena. And we're going to have penalties.
Looks like Ruutu's going to get it. Don't forget, there are some marked men here in the Calgary Flames. Jelena went off with an injury and came back in game six. Stefan Yell, the same thing. Gauthier now out. And Calgary famed defenseman with all the minutes they played. Vancouver will work on them as well, but you have to be disciplined doing it. And here's Ruutu giving Jelena an extra shove, trying to sit on him. Do whatever you can to get him out of the game, but it's going to cost him 2 minutes.
So it's the first power play of the game for Calgary. Jarkko Ruutu, who had the icebreaker in game six, sits in the box as the Flames look for the first goal of Game 7. Revere and Leopold with Lombardi, Nilsson, and Yell to start. A couple of guys out there that are more accustomed to being on the penalty kill than the power play. Ian Nilsson and Yell. Leopold back in his own zone. Here's Marcus Nilsson sending it around. Yell looking for it against Jovanovski. Lombardi followed up. Lost it to Jovanovski. Regeer will keep it in. Robin Regeer with three assists in Game 6. Lombardi in the corner. After Jovanovski jolted Yell. Lombardi redirects the puck to Yell. Now Lombardi looks to the point. Couldn't get much on it. And Rychinski, who's back, sends it down the ice.
Nerves caught Lombardi there a couple of times in this power play. He's a young guy, and he hasn't seen many Game 7s. Not at this level. He hasn't seen any. This is his first.
Now again was out. He'll fire it around. Jelena looks for it from the far side. Tied up by Salah. Puck squirted in front. And away goes Matt Cook with Morrison. And Allen steps up, and he was loose on the right side. And they couldn't get the puck across. Jelena regains possession. 30 seconds left. And the power play for Calgary. Less than 7.5 to go in period one. Jelena missed Allen with the hit. Knocked down at the point. Nice play by Ferris. High on the glass. Down for Jelena. He's hit by Salo. Allen along the board. Morrison for Cook. And Matt Cook will work his way through center. In no particular hurry. Gets it down the ice. And he'll get a change. And both teams 0-for-1 on the power play here in the first as Ruutu returns. And not a shot on Calgary's first power play of the night.
That's a tough icing. One more step, and that would have been okay. And the Calgary Flames now a face-off in their own zone. I mentioned the marked men for the Calgary Flames. There's Jelena going in hard with Sopel. He goes off for a period of time in Game 6. There is the Gauthier injury that's put him out of this series. And then Stephen Yell in the first overtime could hardly get off the ice. In fact, after that, all he did was take faceoffs.
Well, the ranks are thinning. Steve Monador in because Tony Lidman out earlier in the series. And now the injury to Denny Gauthier. Chris Clark played that with a high stick, and it rolled in on Alex Auld. And Clark, a big inspiration in the comeback two nights ago.
Yeah, I talked to Clark this morning, and he grew up just near Hartford, Connecticut, and one of his childhood idols, Jeff Sanderson, who he's playing against here tonight for the Vancouver Canucks, played junior in Springfield in a junior program that has graduated such players as Billy Guerin, Scott Lachance, Mike Komisarek. So it's interesting to see the different areas in the U.S. now where players are starting to come out of.
And Chris Clark was paid a nice compliment when he was compared with Greg Gilbert. The style of player. Here's a shot. Traffic all down. Niemann on the doorstep. And that was close as Commodore sends it back in. All fails to stop it up. Nilsson looks for Niemann, and Brendan Morrison coolly dispatches the puck out to center. Now Morrison digs in. His shot weak and wide. Naslund on the near side. Back for Morrison, who has scored a game winner in the series, set up the other two Canuck game winning goals. Nilsson from long range, just wide of the net. After it goes again, played by Sopel, and now down the ice. Turning with it is Regeer. And he has certainly got a lot of great reviews in this series, including those from the Canuck coaching staff who have been most impressed with Robin Regeer's play. Here's Sanderson digging in, slowed up by Ferentz. Henrik Sedin behind the net. And Greg Conroy there to take it back for Calgary. Conroy up ice. Over the line, Rick Warner loose. He shoots it high. And that hits the netting. In behind Alex Auld. Still scoreless at GM Place. Like all of us, Mike Keane was rocked with the news yesterday that Burns is battling cancer. Mike Keane's first pro coach in Sherbrooke was Pat Burns, and he told me yesterday he doesn't think he'd be in the NHL without the experience of playing under Pat Burns, who took him to Montreal the following year. He's been in the NHL 16 years, and he, like all of us, extends our best wishes to Pat.
Yeah, Pat, everybody in the hockey family is thinking about you and knows you'll beat this one.
Crawford with some eloquent words about Pat Burns this morning. Stephan Jelle deep in Vancouver ice. Pass picked off by Linden. Gets it ahead. Daniel Sedin swings it out. Back to get it, Andrew Ference. He's paired with Brett Warner now in the absence of Denny Gauthier. Sean Donovan deep with Brent Sokol on his back. Picked up by Lombardi. He'll swing it to the far corner. Sokol out to center. Regier gloves it down and flips it into the Vancouver bench.
Well, Regier, as you mentioned, Mark Crawford was one of the coaches saying to us this morning, he's come into his own. Robin Regier's been a real problem for us throughout this series. His first pass out of the zone is strong. He's done an excellent job on all the Vancouver Canuck forwards using the body. And his positional play is terrific as well.
What a foundation Daryl Sutter has on defense with Robin Regier, Jordan Leopold, Brett Warner, Dion Phaneuf, not far away. Playing in Red Deer and regarded as the best young defenseman in the Western Hockey League. And maybe the best in a long time. Eric Malik scoops it out, 4:04 left. First period, Jovanovski has to go back to get it. Here's Malik playing with a half visor. He tried a full cage, but admitted this morning as much as he'd like to wear it, he just couldn't see the puck in his skates. Boy, Mike Keane has had a physical first period. He gets tangled up there with Monador on the forecheck. Now Conroy in some difficulty. Monador trying to help him out. Keane put it in front. Monador there. And a former teammate of Alex Alds in North Bay finally gets it out of harm's way. There's a pass nearly broken up by Jerome Iginla. It's sent back into the Calgary zone. Shots are now 6-5 in favor of the Flames as Commodore hit Yell with the pass. He couldn't control it. Linden will turn back with Brad May and Keane, three veterans, lose possession of the puck. Iginla with counter. And look at Keane back hard. And now standing up, Iginla was Olin. Crashing in was Andrew Ference. Iginla now with it. Couldn't get it to Marcus Nielsen. Jovanovski on his knees lost it. Here's a loose puck in front, and it's steered wide by Iginla as May on his knees couldn't freeze the puck. And Jerome Iginla's had three first period chances now.
And Matias Olin was absolutely run over by Ferris after he was battling with Iginla on the half court.
Now Olin tries to slow things down. Jovanovski flips it high into center. Bumped down by Leopold, and they're going to call a hand pass on the play.
T.S. Olin was sick in game 3 and 4 and didn't have a lot of energy. He seems to be getting his energy back now. He said he felt much better in game 5 and 6, but he won't feel very good after this. Ferentz catches him with his head down and runs him over. And Joel McGinley thought he had one here right in the slot. He swoops the puck from underneath the shin pad of the defender and just misses the far side.
Now Sokol plays it in to the Calgary zone. Regier with Henrik Sedin tailing him. They get tied up and Sanderson's got it. Daniel Sedin loose in the high slot. Sanderson works out. Tried to drop it off. Niemann sticks with his man and Lombardi will regain possession. Outlets to Donovan and out come the Flames. Leopold jumps up on the rush. Three inside the Vancouver zone. And Leopold's shot is blocked. Billy Niemann leads it along the boards for Donovan and back out as Leopold unable to stay in Vancouver territory.
Calgary's defense have been very active in this first period, much more than in the last couple of games, as they've been getting some chances coming in late.
Cut up by Ference down the ice, no icing on the play. And we have 90 seconds remaining in the opening period of game 7. Greg Conroy nearly gave it up to Matt Cook. Ferentz, who backed him up, puts it deep. Olin after, Schillinger lines him up, slows him down. Along the boards, Warner, tied up by Naslund. Iginla works from the corner against Morrison. Put a long look, now it's Schillinger. in the late stages of the period. Coming out in front. Although the puck is Zellerman. Nailed by Salo.
Good work by Vancouver's defense there to box out the Flames so they couldn't get in the slot. Early in this series, Calgary was walking out of the corner. Not on this play. And Jelena tries to take the point right from the corner out to the front of the net. Keep an eye on how Matias Roll and Salo here just box them out. And Ault has no problem then picking up the loose puck.
Marty Jelena wanted us to mention a happy birthday to his 7-year-old daughter, Morgan. Celebrating on the same day as Robin Regier. Here's Rychinski and fires right on Kiprasov. Rebound Chubarov to Rychinski. Back to the point. Here's Jovanovski, a shot. Kicked away by Kiprasov. Off the glass, pulled down by Jovanovski. He's nailed by Clark. And Jovanovski falls on the puck in a little extracurricular. After the whistle, as Nielsen takes down a Canuck.
And again, route two from behind nails Stefan Yell. And once again, as I mentioned, they're marked men. And here's Jovanovski with a terrific save. That helps when you're that big. And if you can keep it rolling, fellas, we're not going to have time, but route two came in right afterwards and just nailed Stefan Yell.
Half minute remaining. In the first period, Leopold. At center by the Sedins. Along the boards of Kinla. Tied up by Olin. And Sopel hitmans the puck. Kicked back out. And the playoff side is Regier. Soccer style, got it out of the Calgary zone.
And again, you know when players are hurt. And then you know it. You make them pay. Any way you can in a playoff series, particularly late in a playoff series.
Performance by Stefan Yell over 20 minutes the other night, playing hurt, and he won 25 of 36 faceoffs. Brent Sopel back in his own zone, and that will do it for the opening period. And any thoughts that the Flames were going away after losing Game 6 on home ice have been dispelled here in the opening period of Game 7. Shots were 7-6 in favor of Vancouver in a scoreless first period in Game 7.
And if you're a Calgary Flames player right now, you must be happy to get out of the first period of play unscathed. Meanwhile, Vancouver started well, and then I thought they sat back a little bit as the period progressed. Let's see if they get a better start here once again to start off period two.
Shots were 7-6 in favor of Vancouver. 4 from their defensemen, 3 of the 6 shots for the Flames by their captain, Jerome Iginla. The Sedins and Trevor Linden start up front. Marcus Nielsen broke up the first pass, and now Andrew Ferentz will log the most ice time for Calgary. 8 minutes, 19 seconds. That's the first time in the series that Ferentz has topped the time list. So he'll log more ice in the absence of Denny Gauthier. Up ahead, off the stick of Daniel Sedin. Kiprasov slowed it. And an outlet pass on the tape ahead for Nielsen. Here's Conroy. Over the line, working against Sopel. A backhand well wide. Flames changing. Henrik Sedin fans on it. Again, look, couldn't thread the needle as he tried to get it deep. And the Canucks get it to center, and they'll try and get a change in. It's the long change here in the second period for both teams. For both teams. Mike Keane after it in the quarter. He'll give it up to Olin. Now Rychinski smothered by Leopold. Matias Olin. Blocked by Conroy. Sends it wide of the net. And Jelen on the near side trying to catch up with it. It'll ricochet all the way back in the Vancouver zone. Jelena ties up Sokol. Gets his stick to the under the arm of Sokol, but the Canucks are able to get it to center. Ferentz belted by Rychinski as he plays it back in deep. And Vancouver continues to jolt the Calgary defenseman at every turn. Ferentz back to regroup in his own zone while the Canucks are changing. Off the boards in front of the Canuck bench, broken up by Naslin. He'll get it deep. There's Cook. First man in. Ferentz gets a piece of Cook. Lombardi in support. Up up the right side, kept in and redirected, rolled just wide by Matt Cook. Now Cook gets up on top of Ferentz. Billy Niemann in there. Pressure as Allen stepped up. Cook behind the net. He'll swing it back looking for Naslund. Warner there. Ducks it down. The big line to Vancouver. Trying to get something going. Matt Cook looks to center. And he had his stick impeded, and Lombardi won the battle. And a good one it was to make sure the center pass didn't occur.
A good shift for the big line.
Now a shot by Warner into the glove for Alex Aull.
That was a good shift for the big line by the Vancouver Canucks. That's the best pressure they've had down low all game long, and they had Calgary on the run. And here's Cook working it behind the goal line on Lombardi, and then coming right out front as Niemann missed his check as well, but Lombardi with a pretty good defensive play afterwards to take the heat out of the kitchen.
Trevor Linden coming on to take this face off, and the vet, 5 of 6. 5 wins, a loss, and make it 6 wins out of 7 for Trevor Linden after that clean face-off win in the Vancouver zone. Jovanovski deflecting off the stick of Kobusu, and the puck into the seats for a Game 7 souvenir. And a little activity and a smile from Dan Marinelli behind the net of the Canucks.
I don't think either team really wants to spend too much energy doing this, although it is to Vancouver's favor. With a depleted lineup and a tired lineup that Calgary has going right now, the more leaning and pushing and shoving that Vancouver can do against the Calgary Flames, the better off they'll be. And here's Malik and Ed Jovanovski behind the net. And a little chin wagging going on by everybody.
Every time Stephan Yell's on the ice, somebody is making him pay, but he wins the draw that time. The shot didn't get through.
Every time Yell's on the ice, Linden's taking the draw against him. That's how much they respect Stephan Yell at the faceoff so far. 62% in this series. Linden's 56.
Whoever's had the better of him so far tonight. He lost control of it here. Yell works back in. Yell 3 and 4 through one period in the faceoff circle. Daniel Sedin on the left side. He'll roll it in. Linden will pick up the chase. Steve Monador back. And around for Saprykin, who has some time as the Canucks were in a chain, but Saprykin hit Rychinski with the pass, then sent back in. Linden trapped offside.
Stephan Yell hesitated for a moment on the hit here, and a solid crunch by Ed Jovanovski. You can see from it, he takes a deep breath and gingerly goes back up the ice.
We kept anticipating in the last game we might have seen the last of them, but Stephan Yell just kept coming back out. They called it an intentional offside, brought it right back in the Vancouver zone. Where Conroy again and Jelena try and do some work. Leopold steps up, Jelena up top, flips it into the near corner. There's Aginla, cycles the puck to Conroy, tries to throw it in front, broken up by Sokol. Sokol to Chubarov, and it will come out, and it's Sokol with the puck. He got to the line, rolled it deep. Rychinski after it now. He's slowed up by Leopold. On that right side, Aginla fencing for it, Rutu. Weak shot, Kiprusoff handled it easily. And now it's out, Jelena with the break. As the Canucks were changing, and a glove stuck by Alex Aull, flashing the leather on Marty Jelena.
A careless line change by the Vancouver Canucks on this long change in the second period, and that left Jelena wide open. Now, if we can stop it right now, whoa. Sometimes the goaltender all tends to overplay shots, and there is room on the far side, but a nice glove save to compensate for it. As you can see, he's off his angle on that shot.
Matt Lombardi on the faceoff. Flames got the puck. Ferentz the shot, and it's blocked by Linden off the shin guards and out. Lombardi with points in the first 3 games. Has not scored in the last 3, and he's been playing hurt after blocking a shot in the 5th game here at GM Place. Brett Warner, pounded by Cook. Ferentz misses the pass. Kristoff Olava, rear shift. And Calgary sends it down the ice. We've got a race for it. Donovan wipes out the icing call as he got the stick on it before Malik. Played out to center. Monador in some difficulty there. Swipes at the puck. Play is offside. And that young Calgary defenseman thankful of that.
Monador and Commodore are out together, and they're both right-handed shots. And this is going to present a problem for both. The Monador now on his offside. Now, it's tough enough to come in on the first game in a series in a Game 7, let alone play on your offside. So far, he's had a couple of problems with it in this game in the first period, but we'll keep an eye on that as these two are playing together yet. One's playing on the wrong side.
Salo rifles it in on Kiprusoff. We've hit the five-minute mark of the second period. Another Salo offering that Kiprusoff handles easily. Back in by Henrik Sedin. Sanderson is after it. Monador plays it. Nieminen gets it by Salo out at center. Henrik Sedin will bring it right back in. Here's Sanderson with a room in front. And Daniel Sedin couldn't get a stick on it for the redirect. Nieminen up ice. Oh, let it go. Allen gave it to Conroy, and then Henrik Sedin knocked it back out to center. Robin Regier trying to hook up with Nieminen. Conroy had the stick knocked out of his hands, picks up the lumber again, and Sanderson will deflect it down into Calgary ice. Wholesale change for Vancouver. A pass for Saprinkin too far. Olin lined up by Aginla, but that's an icing call against Calgary. You're watching Hockey Night in Canada.
I mentioned Monador. He's a right-handed shot playing on the left side. Watch this move here. He's on his backhand. Watch what he does. Goes to his forehand, chunks it off the board. That's a pretty good play for a defenseman playing in his first game on his offside.
Face off in the Calgary zone, and it's back out at center. Olin retrieving the puck, and Aginla in pursuit. There's Steve Monador, one of many of the young Calgary Flames, part of the 2001 Calder Cup team. Here's a chance, and Khabarov didn't get good wood. Centers in the goal mouth, and Kiprusoff sprawls to cover that with Mike Keane on the doorstep.
Saprinkin with a pretty good defensive play, first of all, as he makes a strong identification in the slot for the first chance. And Marchinski uses his speed to chip the puck out. And here comes the centering pass. And it's actually Conroy there that identifies the man in the slot, and that's Keane. And before that, just before that, it was Saprinkin who made a pretty good identification on the slot chance as well.
The rookie Lombardi against the veteran Linden. Linden wins the faceoff. Back to Salo, flips it toward the net. Brad May had it in his skates. Got a whack at it, but Kiprusoff's got it.
Smart play by Mark Crawford here. Lombardi, who's been adequate on the faceoff so far in this series, in fact, very good for a youngster, loses against the veteran here, and here's the bouncing puck that Kiprusoff finds. But 51% for Lombardi on the faceoffs, but now Yelko's back on the ice, and that's why.
Yes, Lombardi was their best man in the first period, winning 5 of 8. Yell the most reliable. Now Salo a blast, and that didn't get through the traffic. Flames get it out. You can feel that the momentum shifting Vancouver's way suddenly here in what has been the most cautious game of the series so far. Here's Jelena racing after it. And then lost it, route two. Spins it back the other way. Ferentz icing Vancouver.
And Vancouver, Chris, has started to get some waves going offensively by throwing the puck in deep, working it behind the net. They're winning some offensive draws. And Calgary's losing the puck in the neutral zone a little bit here. And that's creating momentum for Mark Crawford's group to start off this second period. And Linden's on the ice for every faceoff, it seems, winning most of them. He's on again.
Up against Marcus Nielsen, a clean win. Nielsen has really been dominated in the circle this series, and yet he won the draw in the defensive zone that led to Vancouver's winning goal. in the third overtime period on Saturday night. That's what disappointed Daryl Sutter the most. They should have had the puck after the faceoff win out of the zone. But a mistake cost them. And now, here's Donovan with some room. Sean Donovan cut off by Jovanovski. And at the last second, Jovanovski knocked it away. Then into the glove of Aube. And now Morrison will do some pushing with Niemanen. As Aube gets out of the traffic.
Well, the speedster Donovan was taken off here. And Jovanovski with a good play. See how Jovanovski puts his stick into the play first and then takes the man. And that's a smart play. Now here's the chip that I'm talking about that's working so well for Vancouver at the moment. They're just isolating the puck into the corner, and even the defense, that's Malik who's going, and there's some puck possession and two Canuck forwards wide open in front. The Canucks would have gained solid possession of the puck there.
Face off, Canucks with the puck. They've outshot Calgary 3-2. In this second period, Bonador and Commodore. The door is back on the blue line for Calgary here. And a puck out of play.
So on entries going into the Calgary zone, all Vancouver want to do is keep it away from the middle. They're concerned about the pressure that Calgary shows you through the middle of the ice, so that they're just going to chip it off the boards, pass the defense, and try to get into some foot races and wear down Calgary's defense after their long evening in Game 6.
McGinley on the ice. Goals in each of the wins for Calgary in this series. Three first period shots. Quiet so far in the second. Sabrykin back on the big line for the Flames. Commodore to Conroy. There's McGinley. Firing it in. Remember the outset of the series. McGinley talked about drawing on the lessons learned from the Olympic experience in Salt Lake City. See if that stands him in good stead here in a Game 7 sort of gold medal situation. Knocked down by Naslin. Hit by Yell. There's Leopold to backhand it out and down. McGinley tried to water ski off Allen. Unsuccessful. And Allen off the glass and out. Regeer off Yell. Back in deep. Nilsson on the forecheck as the puck ricocheted in on Alex Auld and Drake Millen. It was a very positive experience for Jerome McGinley in Salt Lake City.
Was it over? There's a goal going to the net for McGinley. One of two. And he was tremendous in that Olympic experience. We asked him this morning, Chris, if he's been able to draw much from. He said, no, not really. It was just fun.
Shot knocked down in front.
I know you were chasing for a gem on that one, but he really didn't give you much, did he?
Wanted to know if he was going to use any of anybody's motivational speeches from Salt Lake City.
Had the Clark Kent investigative reporting going, but to no avail for a change.
Instead, quiet leadership. Everybody seemed to be playing in the Daryl Sutter mold here. Flames.
Good try.
I noticed you were doing more interviews. Asking questions this morning.
For free, that was the worst part of it.
Chris Clark along the boards. He'll dump it out. Most of the action here in the second period between the blue lines. Now Vancouver sends it in. Ryan Finn Calgary with the puck. Pass Daniel Sedin right down the ice. Jovanovski gets the icing call against Calgary, and this is as slow a pace as we've seen in the entire series.
It sure is. This is the first time that I can remember that this series has walked a bit. And perhaps these teams deserve it, the way they have gone at such a torrid pace throughout the whole first six games and in period one of this seventh game. Again, Linden out against Lombardi. Let's see what happens here. Oh, Lombardi gets kicked out. Now McGinley off a try against Linden. This could be an opportunity for Vancouver.
He hasn't had to take many, but he wins this one.
Wrong.
Clutch face-off win. Regeer lost an edge, but recovers, and the Flames get it out. 10-20 left, second period. It's a five-shot second period so far. I'm not sure if there have been any chances.
Another ice against Calgary.
And Sopel, I believe it was Sopel, just got Saprykin. It might have been a knee. And Saprykin is favoring his left leg as he goes off the ice. And let's have a look at it. It was right at the boards. Here comes Sopel. Knee-to-knee contact on that play. And Saprykin goes straight down, although he hobbles back to the bench. And there's Trevor Linden trying to give Regier a ride. And again, as I emphasized in the first period, Vancouver trying to hit as much as they possibly can. They feel the longer this game goes, the better off it is to their advantage.
And the Detroit Red Wings and San Jose Sharks are saying, go ahead and hit, boys.
Mark Howe, by the way, is in the building for the Detroit Red Wings watching this game, and I am sure San Jose has a representative of some sort.
Commodore just went over the boards. Brent Warner is staying out, so Commodore had to retrace his steps. Nilsson overskates the puck at center. Brad May gets it back. And now a Jovanovski pass goes the length of the ice, and Warner beats May for yet another icing in a very cautious second period.
We're getting into a game here where both teams are afraid to make a mistake. And that's why we're seeing the caution that we are at the moment, and both teams are not going anywhere near the middle of the ice for that very reason. Linden out again to take another faceoff. This is ridiculous. It's every time now.
Well, it's so critical. It may come down to one faceoff, won or lost, to decide it. Linden at 56.5% in the series. Conroy moves early. He gets waved. So Jelena will take it on his backhand. And the Flames nearly came up with a puck. Good second effort. Vancouver saves it. And Rychinski goes to the attack. Long wrist shot off the target. Chubarov hit from behind by Conroy. Penalty upcoming as all vacates the net. Conroy is going to argue the call, saying the man he hit turned. To no avail.
But he won't win the argument. Now that's from behind, and he pushes hard enough. Now Conroy gets tossed out on this faceoff circle. This is two. Look at him try to cheat there in Linden. The advantage Vancouver has is that Chubarov is on the ice as well. Two center icemen for Vancouver every time. Conroy is the only natural center on the ice for Calgary, so they don't mind when Conroy gets kicked out of the faceoff circle. They try to make that happen.
Second power play of the game. Leopold just played it back into goaltender Kiprusoff with the short side. Rychinski's out with Morrison and Naslin. That's Rychinski battling behind the net. There's Naslin. Salo at the left point. Jovanovski poised at the right point. Rychinski stationed in front of Kiprusoff, who's having trouble seeing past the winger. Here's Naslin, bad angle, shot blocked by Leopold. Now Rychinski. Back to the captain with Yell hacking at Marcus Naslin. Brendan Morrison, Jovanovski, a shot right on as he moved up from the point position to take the pass. Morrison now back to Rychinski. Jovanovski retreated to the right point. Here's Rychinski. Looking dangerous, Naslin right on, Kiprusoff down, and he's got it just a couple of inches off the line.
Vancouver's changed their power play look a little bit in Game 7 here. Remember earlier in this series, Jovanovski would go right to the front of the net and stand in front of the net. And here's Rychinski going down to Naslin. He tries the short side shot, but before this, Jovanovski now comes from the top, from his point position. So now they've changed it a bit. Before, Jovanovski was already in front of the net. Now Vancouver's keeping both defensemen back to the point and then stepping in late. A little adjustment here on the power play for Vancouver in Game 7 so far.
Been a long time between goals for Jovanovski. Offside the call. He has not scored since January the 13th. 18 games plus the 25 he missed with an injury. Remember, he had 7 last year in the postseason, including a 4-game goal streak.
Kiprusoff having a little chat with Watson just moments ago, and I know what he's talking about. Keep my crease clear. He's trying to go the official a little bit into perhaps watching a little more carefully in front of the crease.
Wachinski was really cramping his style earlier in this power play. Now 40 seconds remaining in the man advantage. Sanderson and the Sedins, Oland and Sopel. Matias Oland chased by Aginla. Here's Daniel. Jeff Sanderson. Daniel Sedin and Oland. Sopel on the outside for the moment. Sanders played it off the back of the net and now to his brother. They'll exchange passes and move in. Give and go. Kiprasov down, and he held it out. Huge stop by Kiprasov on a nifty. Give and go play. Sanderson shot ricochets wide. And Conroy gets set to return. And they survive it after that close call. A pair of shots. And the puck out at center. There's Conroy out of the box. Away he goes. Jerome Aginla scores! What a counterattack! And Jerome Aginla has the icebreaker in game 7.
When you are a goalie at the other end and you know there's a player coming out of the box, it scares the daylights out of you because everybody's trying offensively and Aginla's yelling, screaming for the puck. Conroy doesn't see him, but he hears him. As soon as he hears him, he'll just throw the puck towards an area and Aginla just comes steaming down the slot with that quick release, puts it right through the goaltender Alex Hall.
12:50, the time of the goal, Aginla's fourth of the series. He scored first in game 2. He scored the empty netter in game 4, the game winner in game 5. All three previous goals in Calgary wins.
Now Lombardi here is really smart. He's going to get the puck, and what he does, he's waiting for Conroy to get to the right angle. Stop it here, guys. Whoa, there's Conroy. Watch what Lombardi does. Conroy will circle back this way. There goes the pass. Here comes Aginla. And the Canucks just let him go. They don't identify it. Goal. 1-0 Calgary.
Aginla from Conroy and Lombardi. 12:50, the time of the game's first goal. Now Chris Clark. Patrick Jovanovski tied up behind the net. Marcus Wilson battles. Jovanovski's lost the glove. Puck flipped ahead and Malik's got it as Jovanovski picks up his equipment and Linden starts in. Trevor Linden plays it deep. Matt Cook just pumped goaltender Kiprasov and we've got a penalty upcoming against Vancouver. Cook is going to argue that Kiprasov was off the post in his way, but to no avail, and we've seen this time and time again in the series.
We've seen a lot of this, and remember Kiprasov talking to the official moments ago saying, look after my crease. Now he put the bug in the official's ear, and now Cook bumps into Kiprasov. That just playing as a penalty. You can't do this. As Cook just loses where Kiprasov is the net and where the net is. He gets a little too aggressive on the forecheck.
Calgary with a chance of the power play. They take a 2-goal lead. Conroy Aginla, Jelena, Leopold Regeer. There is veteran Marty Jelena. Back to Leopold, and the former Canucks got it again. Moving in, Regeer parks in front. Salo works him over. Aginla. Conroy is covering at the point. Aginla trying to walk right in. Regeer got a swat at it. Didn't get much on it, but all kept it out. Well, that time it was Regeer charging in to cause a little confusion in front of the Vancouver net. Leopold turned back by Wachinski. In the game 7 for Vancouver last year, the team that scored first lost. They gave up the first goal against St. Louis. They scored the first one against Minnesota. Wachinski with the puck, and he'll fire it back. And over a minute gone in the penalty to Matt Cook. 5:10 left, second period.
There have been 7 goalie interference penalties so far in this series. 7.
Here's Kovacu, nailed by Salo. And some room for Wachinski on the wing. He gives it up. Saprykin nailed, gets it deep. Daryl Sutter. Has 3 youngsters out, Saprykin, Lombardi, and Kovacu. Trying to put some energy into this power play. He's also got Commodore and Monador. So Sutter getting some time. time for the youngsters with the man advantage. With
he's their turn back. He's giving them a bit of a rest here. The big boys an opportunity to do that.
Potador, great pass. Yell. Had a little trouble with it. It was too hot. Now it's Wilson working along the board. Penalized player is back on the ice. One shot, that's all. As Calgary fails to expand its lead. Here comes Brendan Morris into the attack. Hook loose. Linden has it. Fires right on. Trevor Linden, the all-time Canuck playoff scoring leader, still looking for his first point of this series. Hey, that must be Owner's Row on the left. John McCaw, the owner of the Vancouver Canucks, one of the owners of the Phoenix Coyotes. The guy who appreciated what Jerome Iginla did at the gold medal game in Salt Lake City. None other than number 99.
But he has your glasses on.
Looks pretty good, doesn't he? Calgary clears it down the ice. Less than 4 minutes remaining in the second period. Brendan Morrison up for Naslin. Here comes the Vancouver big line. Morrison a shot. Blocker to the corner by Kiprasov. Olin kicked it loose, and now he's trapped. Has to hustle back. Jelena scoops it into Vancouver ice. All leaves the net. Knocked down at the point by Leopold. He gets it deep for Iginla. Jelena lurking around the net. Iginla parks in front. Leopold throws it at the net. Knocked down in front as Olin was all over Iginla. Here's Jelena in front. Backhand. Stopped by Auld. Somebody forgot Marty Jelena at the side of the net.
Well, that's been the issue for Vancouver in this series. They've been losing players in the slot after some low work by Calgary. Now, Olin here is on the other side of the net. And as you can see, Jelena is able. Two Canuck players in front, but all the posts on the wrong side of the net. Jelena wide open. Morrison is late getting across, but Alex Auld closes the door with an excellent save.
Earlier in the year, Marty Jelena played his 1,000th NHL game, and one of the first people to congratulate him by phone, one of his heroes, Guy Lafleur. And now Jelena in his 128th Stanley Cup playoff game. He will pull back in his own zone. Off the glass, pass Malik. Romanowski for Vancouver. Picked off at center by Saprykin. He'll wheel it in. Under 3 minutes to go in the second. Iginla the goal. And it's the Canucks that need a spark. Monador gives it away. Here's Ruutu. Shot blocked by Commodore. But a penalty upcoming after the Monador giveaway. Ruutu. Looks like he got a stick in the face.
And Monador is going to get the penalty for the slash. Commodore got hit with the puck. And again, I mentioned in the first period about being an offside defenseman when you haven't had a lot of ice time as well. And Monador here going back for the puck. And because he's a right-handed shot, he can't spin and protect the puck. And it looks like there's the penalty there to Monador. And there's the puck in the ankle to Commodore. Broadcaster's nightmare, isn't it?
Vancouver has scored 6 of their 8 power play goals here at GM Place. They're 0 for 2 tonight.
Commodore.
When the doors are going against Morrison, it really gets confusing.
That's not bad.
There's Olin sending it in. Henrik Sedin along the boards. There's Daniel. He's tripped up, stays with it. For Henrik. Cheating now down is Olin. On the back door play, Daniel holds, fires, and Sanderson couldn't redirect. Sokol keeps it alive for Vancouver. Warner clubbed it ahead, chopped out by Sokol. Warner works over Henrik Sedin. Sanderson dug it out. Sokol across, Olin with it. Knocked down in front, Daniel. Here's Sokol, and look at that stick. Helicopter high off the netting. I haven't seen a stick fly that high. And it negates a Canuck chance and prompts another editorial comment from my analyst.
You got that right. Chance to score in a 7th game with traffic in front of the net, and the stick goes. And you have to wonder how many times this is going to happen before the coaches catch on to it.
66 seconds remain in the Vancouver power play as they look for the equalizer. Under 2 minutes to go in period two.
That could have been a goal. That could have been a goal, and the stick just explodes on Sopel.
This is a guy who scored 10 times during the regular season. Now Salo's out. Morrison heads them up ice. Jovanovski. So no goals for Jovanovski or Sopel yet. Here's Naslund, and the pass broken up in front. Marcus Naslund left unattended.
He was in position A, and what happened?
To have another look at that. Morrison, Naslund back in with Rychitsky. There's Rychitsky, missed the pass. And now the Canucks are squeezing the stick. Marcus Nielsen in on the penalty kill, and they'll take the scenic route back out. Ferentz, he'll drive it in. Right on, Aug. And he'll freeze it with exactly a minute to go. And yes, this warrants another look. What happened to an unmarked Marcus Naslund?
Naslund was wide open in front. Here's the pass. And a stick from behind looks like it just gets into the stick of Naslund. Keep an eye on the Calgary Flame player's stick, right? No, it just bounces off the stick. I thought initially it might have been a deflection.
Here's a Ginla after a face-off win. Shot ricochets all the way back in the Calgary zone. Cook in on Ferentz. Sokol moves up. Again, the final minute of the period, and Montador is back on the ice. Canucks did not get a shot on that third power play. And they're still chasing Calgary from behind. Sokol in front, off the skate. Keane whacks at it. Kiprusoff down. How did that stay out? And a holding call coming up against Calgary. But Mike Keane with a glorious chance to tie. Instead, they'll have to settle for another power play.
And Vancouver's coming, and they're coming on strong, but they can't seem to find the handle. It pucks in tight. Sopel with a terrific redirect here, a pass to the redirect. And I believe Keane shot it, and somehow Kiprusoff got his left pad on it in the scramble.
And you can see Linden had it caught up in his skates. Can't kick at it.
No, it never got to Kiprusoff at all. As in front of the net, the puck was stopped. And I think it was Rhett Warner, but I'm not altogether sure. And he gets the call for holding the stick afterwards.
Warner had Linden's stick all tied up, and that's why Linden could only play with it in his skates, and he knew he couldn't kick it in the net.
So Keane had a wide open net, and a save goal once again in the slot from a desperate Calgary Flames group who collapsed down in front of Kiprusoff.
So right back to the power play. Morrison, Cook, Naslund. Salo, Jovanovski. Here's Jovo. Naslund. Shot. Kiprusoff's got it. Look at Cook. Right on the porch. Kiprusoff cool again in another bounce back game.
Kiprusoff is so good at getting into an area where he can make the save. Now watch what he does here. We can stop it right here. Whoa. He uses these guys, Cook and the player to your right, as goaltenders. And then he gets in the middle where the puck may end up. And it does. Morrison and Cook were pretty good goalies for him. He just moves into an area where the puck can go and does have an opportunity to go coming in through the slot.
20.2 to go in this second period. Flames control the faceoff. Leopold gets it down the ice. And Vancouver will have to hustle if they're going to generate another chance here in the second period. Jovanovski has Salo loose over the line. And he stopped up at the line. Will appeal the call, but that's offside. 3.9 seconds on the clock.
Well, the Canucks are going to have to go in their room, and I know what they're going to say. Exactly what they said after regulation time in Calgary. Don't panic. Stick with the program. And that's what Trevor Linden's message was and Mike Keane's message was as we got Naslund wide here, but they lose the draw anyway.
And that will do it. Period number two. The shots were 10-6 Vancouver. They have outshot Calgary 17-12 through 40 minutes of play. But Jerome Iginla scores his fourth of the series from Craig Conroy and Matt Lombardi. The Heat's on the Canucks In Game 7, it's 1-0 Flames. Here we go, the final regulation period of the series. The Calgary Flames with a one-goal lead. Brett Warner in the box, a minute 28 remaining on his penalty. So the Canucks, in need of a goal, have the man advantage to start the third.
And the most positive thing of Vancouver's game so far has been their power play. It's been excellent. They've done everything but score so far.
The Fact Stats team of Dave Moyer and Corey Launeberg have 7 Vancouver chances in the game and 6 on the power play. Wojcinski after the puck, and it deflects into the benches with 63 seconds of power play time left.
Well, they've altered their power play a little bit. They haven't ran Jovanovski in the slot like earlier in the series, and it's worked. And they've worked the give and go down low against Calgary and had several good chances, just haven't been able to either sell Kiprusoff or haven't had a little puck luck in front of them.
Shallow dumps it in. Morrison with a hit on Regier. Leopold, the backhand, lofting it back into Vancouver ice. Now Wojcinski goes to the bench. Daniel Sedin checks in. The power play goal in game 6. He had only 1 all season long. Here's Morrison. There's Daniel. Flips it in behind the net. Morrison warded off. Nazl plays it to the point. Matthias Olin, who's on the losing end of the head-to-head battle, with Aginla shot in, and Kiprusoff there to make the stop. And Aslan tried to kick it loose, couldn't get it to a teammate. Calgary clears, and a dozen seconds remain in the red Warner penalty. Here comes Olin. Up for Sanderson. In the Calgary ice, that puck should have been cleared and now will be as Warner returns. A pair of power play shots, but still a one-goal lead for Calgary. Here's Sopel losing it. A chance and all. A stop off Lombardi. Now powering in front. Donovan, a shot. Lombardi whacking at it. Auld covering it. As we check our Gillette game file.
Well, the only goal in the hockey game so far. Joel McGinley coming out the penalty box. Throws it right between Alex Auld's legs. And Auld's been strong, allowing just one goal in 82-22. And Kiprusoff steady as a rock so far for the Calgary Flames.
And Aginla, the lead ice time man through 2 periods on either side at 16 minutes and 25 seconds. So the lead horse has been out in front for Calgary tonight. Sallow back, an icing call against the Flames. Early in this third period in a quiet GM place.
I'm not surprised that Aginla's going to play. First of all, the bench has been shortened for Daryl Sutter. And not only that, when you got a guy like Aginla that can play a lot of high minutes in a big game, you play him.
Conroy wins the draw away from Chubarov. Warner flips it out. There's Olin. And Sokol. Between those two now, they are minus 12 in the series. There it's battling. Sabrikin on the wall. Rutu there. Chubarov looking for those puck, but it's found by Conroy. And Harris watched by Keane. Mike Keane, the only even strength chance Vancouver generated. Here goes Aginla against Olin, who cuts him off at the pass. And now the play is offside at the Vancouver line.
And the reason for all those minuses is Jerome Aginla. 4 goals, 2 assists, 6 points in the series. A plus 6 now. Aginla there does some nice work. Pardon me, Olin does some nice work against Aginla. But Sokol, in my opinion, hasn't been nearly as good as he should be in this series. It's not so much Olin's work, but Sokol has to be a little bit better in this third period against the big line.
The unsung Canuck player of the year in the regular season. He has an offensive talent that has not been harnessed in this series. Jovanovski starts the Canucks out. The pass for Naslin with Morrison streaking down the right side. with Cook, and Morrison shot. Cook rebound loose. Morrison unable to get a stick on it with Kiprusoff down and out. Close call. Best chance of the third. As Yell fires it in on Aulb, and he'll smother that.
A set play by the Vancouver Canucks generates some speed, and Brendan Morrison has been the go-to guy. But keep an eye on this. There he goes down the wing, and here's a little tip from Naslin. And now it's a two-on-two, but Morrison is just steaming down the right side, and that creates a chance to score. How about Morrison in full speed, cuts to the middle, and gets away a very good-looking snapshot.
And Regier and Kobosu just impeding Morrison before he could capitalize on that open net.
And that's a set play out of the zone. And Morrison comes late down the wing. Naslin just tips it up to him. And here is the save. Kiprusoff again. He is so flexible. He does the splits almost every time. And he battles back, and he has the ability to scramble well also.
That's a little of the flash and dash, but we haven't seen as much from the Canucks as we do throughout the regular season. That is the Flames, and how much of it is just the Canucks not firing at all cylinders. A Ginla backhand, and it's under the paddle of Aulb long enough to get a whistle.
Aulb's done a nice job of recognizing those wraparound attempts. A Ginla has a lot of pressure on him, so there's no chance that a Ginla can get it up. And here's Aulb peeking properly, paddle down. He'll stay down because of the pressure from Olin. He knows that Aginla's not going to get that backhand high, so it's paddled down, and good rebound control by Aulb.
Trevor Linden, the only Canuck to have a winning faceoff percentage tonight, adds to that with a win there. Linden 12 and 6 through 40 minutes. The other centers all have less than a 50% average tonight. 4 minutes into the third period. Here comes Sokol off the boards, redirected by Cook deep. Rychinski goes after. Cook now with Linden and Rychinski. Trevor Linden, who scored in game 7 against St. Louis a year ago. Rychinski, he put it to the net. Olin, right out in front. Couldn't get it from the skate to the stick for a shot. Goes call, Linden. Looks rink wide. Sokol fires off a skate. And it goes high over the net. Kiprusoff never saw it. Olin in deep, and the defense really moving up to the attack now. Olin knocked off stride, lost his helmet. Puck out at center.
Now Vancouver starting to activate their defense.
Giveaway there, though, and Saprykin just got out of the way of a Sokol hit.
And Olin just took off down the boards, got a chance to score, and then stayed in Calgary's zone. And we'll see a lot more of that now with 15 to go in regulation time.
Remember, 47 goals from the Canuck blue line during the regular season. Among the top in the NHL, and away goes Jovanovski. He's got Keane loose, Sanderson to the net, Keane shot. High off the glass, off target. Clark takes a hit from Jovanovski, but gets it out to center. Malik will play it back in as the Canucks try to up the tempo. Jordan Leopold. Off the glass, blocked by Malik, but chopped away by Clark. And you know if the Canucks are jumping, they may be vulnerable on the other side of that. And it may make things very interesting here in the third.
But they've got to now. They've got to go. It's desperation time here for Vancouver. Here comes Olin coming in off the point position. And a bouncing puck, or Olin would have had a terrific chance to score there. Good puck recovery. And then Olin just stays in the zone, but take a seat. Says Rhett Warner.
5.5 minutes gone in the third period. Jerome Aginla, the lone goal scorer here in game 7 so far. Marcus Naslin across for Cook. Couldn't come up with it. Donovan to the red line, down the ice. Aulb has to come up to play it. Out of the reach of Allen, Warner keeps it in. Jelinek dashing after it. Here's Sammy Salo, a cool pass on the tape from Morrison, Cook, and Naslin. Over the line they come. Morrison, check that, Cook just kicked off balance momentarily. And Donovan regains Calgary possession. Jelinek sends it in. Calgary changing. Here's Lombardi. Tying up Olin. And they'll get a whistle in the Vancouver zone. Good job by the rookie, Matt Lombardi.
One man in for Calgary now, and Vancouver starting to get out a lot easier out of their zone. Why is that? Because the gaps are too big. Stop it here. Between forward and defense. And that's why now all of a sudden Vancouver's generating speed in the neutral zone and creating some chances.
On the faceoff, Commodore guides it around the boards in behind the net.
Calgary's way too conservative at the moment now, and perhaps they're getting a little bit tired in this third period. Those gaps are way too big, and that'll hurt them. As you don't want to give that much time and space to Vancouver in the neutral zone.
Almost sprung Aginla that time, and he'll ride Olin into the board. Saprinkin got a piece of Sokol. Remember when they won here in game number 5, Vancouver outshot them 12-2 in the third period. And they didn't like the way they sat on their lead. We'll see if they are better in that department tonight. The Canucks will be in attack mode as Rychinski sends it in.
I think Kiprusoff's going to have to stand on his head here the way this period has gone so far. It's been all Vancouver.
Here's Jovanovski gathering speed as he works through center. Left yell in his wake. Over the line. Broken up. Kept in. Here's a chance. Route 2 shot. Deflects. Up onto the netting.
A very concerned general manager and Brian Burke. Steve Tambellini beside him. They've both done a tremendous job here rebuilding this Vancouver Canuck organization. Brian Burke without a contract, which is absolutely unbelievable to me. He has done a remarkable job. They'd be nuts to let him go.
Absolutely. Here's Jovanovski in front. Naslund shot. Score! Matt Cook scores the goal. And we are tied in game 7. His footing, rolls it in. Remember, Matt Cook had the game winner in game 3.
Well, Calgary gets back to playing the way they should have been playing this whole period. Now they're aggressive again, and Vancouver has to answer to it. Giveaways and bad ones.
And Leopold right back in. Jordan Leopold shot. Hit Malik and went wide. Jovanovski into the net, knocks it ajar. And we'll have a face-off outside, I believe, the Vancouver line.
And there's the goal scorer. It's right off the draw here. And great work here to block so Jovanovski can get the puck. And that was Cook. And then Cook just follows up. So he blocks the man out to give Jovanovski time. Then he spins up and gets the goal. And then all trouble right after this. And oh, what a break. As that puck lands right in the crease. And Stefan Yell almost knocked it into the empty net.
And close now, Auld unable to stop it. In behind the net, Aginla after it against Olin. Conroy with Chubarov whacking at him. Saprinkin testing Auld on the short side. And Rychinski turns away, and now Keane flips it down into the Calgary zone. Monitor jolted by Keane. Puck on the far boards, played ahead from Conroy to Aginla. Sokol to Olin. Stands back in it after a long, quiet, nervous spell. Sokol leads it for the corner. Now it's ahead for Sanderson. Now little Alberta's Jeff Sanderson. Couldn't get it in deep. High in the air. Here's Cook on it again, looking for Sanderson. Sanderson plays, but stopped, and nobody heard the whistle. It's a high stick that knocked the puck down.
I think Matt Cook's going to get
Warner. Wow.
Yep. Cook's going to get a penalty for high sticking Warner.
Warner's
not sure what planet he's on at the moment. He's cut. Will this be two or four? Four is the call. That's careless use of the stick as he clips Rhett Warner in the face.
And the Vancouver argument is that Ferentz jarred Cook to make the stick come up into the face of Warner.
Let's have another look at this.
Was Cook's stick coming up anyway?
Yep. Well, it doesn't matter. Hit him in the face.
It's a four-minute penalty. So the Calgary Flames with a big chance now to regain the lead. They send it in. Gilliner, Conroy, Aginla, who walks out of the corner in a backhand. Right on. Loose puck. Conroy. Leopold. Regier. Shot to the net. And a redirect by Gelina just went wide. Gelina battling with Olin. Back to Conroy, over to Aginla. Salo knocks Aginla down. Gelina, and Conroy gets the puck. Leopold, a shot in front, scores! Jerome Aginla has done it again!
And there's still another power play coming up for Calgary. What a play by Jordan Leopold at the point. This is a major league play by the defenseman as he steps around Trevor Linden trying to block the shot, and then another major league play by Jerome Aginla coming out of the corner. And Salo gets over aggressive. Aginla goes from his backhand to his forehand, left all alone in front. 2-1 Calgary.
His second of the game. We showed you his two goals in the Olympic gold medal game against the United States. This might feel almost as big right now. With under 9.5 minutes to go, the captain has regained the lead for Calgary.
Olin has to box out Aginla somehow here on this play. Craig Conroy before this made a great play from behind the net. And there's Aginla who just walks out in front. Salo's over-aggressive here on Gelina. And here comes Aginla. What a play. I mean, what a play by Aginla in front of the net.
Leopold.
90% of players would tip that. He stops it. He walks around the goaltender all who had no chance at all.
Leopold, Conroy, the assist. Jerome Aginla, four of his five postseason goals here in Vancouver on the road. 25 of his 41 in the regular season away from home. And he's trying to fire the Flames to Detroit for round two. Now kept in by Saprykin. Saprykin handing it off. They're still on the power play, and Ferentz now at the point with Commodore. He gives it to Conroy. Conroy in the high slot, played back to Commodore. Ferentz with some room. Back to Commodore, he's got a big shot. He takes it, and off Chubarov, wide of the net. Commodore again to Ferentz. 8.5 minutes left in the third period. Aginla takes a look. Here's Commodore. Knocks it down. Plays it deep. Knocks on it. And Keane gets it down the ice. Less than a half minute remaining in a costly double minor to Matt Cook. Robin Regier. He'll wrap it in. Along the boards, past the Flames and Morrison. Rich back with route two. Jovanovski joins the rush. Jovanovski into the corner. Donovan there. Got it to Leopold, and he'll turn it up in a hurry. Morrison towing in behind. Donovan. Cook returns as Donovan fires it in on all. So Vancouver back at full strength, but a power play goal has given Calgary its second lead of the game. Warner back out after the repairs of the high stick. Yell after it with Chris Clark. Clark to the corner. Spins off Henrik Sedin. Andrew parrots a shot. Deflecting wide. Clark on it. He'll try and tuck it in short side. Henrik Sedin stands him up. And Aub is on it. 7:14 to go. Calgary up by one.
This is all about puck battle by Jerome McGinley. He's going to get tied up here with Salo. And Olin just takes off to the boards. And when Olin takes off, guess who comes back in front of the net in a two-on-one? An over-aggressive play by Salo. He lets Aguila come out as well. And Aguila with a terrific move in front to give the Calgary Flames the lead.
From the face-off, Flames control. That's Conroy again along the boards. Whiffed on it. And Linden starts back. Andrew Ferris losing it. Trevor Linden works the corner. Conroy on him. Here's Linden. Back to Olin. From the line, weak and wide. Sabrekin on the other side. Tries to chop it out. Well, down by Linden. Henrik Sedin finds Linden in the slot. A backhand. And it hit Warner and didn't get through. It looked promising for the Canucks. They've still got it going. And Sopel shot. Hits somebody in front. Linden sprawls, but Sabrekin's got it. And he will get it out as Vancouver comes right back in pursuit of another tie goal.
If Vancouver keeps going like this and keeps driving, they will draw a penalty here with 6:23 to go, but they got to keep their feet moving. They got to keep the forecheck going and activate their defense as much as possible. It's desperation time for Mark Crawford's group, and they got to pull everything out of the hat now.
Prior to tonight, Jerome McGinley had scored in 35 games this year. The Flames had suffered only 5 regulation losses in those games. And he has 2 tonight, trying to enhance that stat and get the Flames to round 2. But Morrison has other ideas. Naslin has room and a shot. Knocked down along the way. Morrison has it tied up in his skates. Yell there quickly. Works the boards. Nielsen trying to wrap it out. Kept in by Morrison. Now Regier after it. And he plays it off the netting. And we'll have another face-off in the Calgary zone. Trevor Linden on this face-off. 14-7 on the night. Yell gets him that time. And up ahead to Marcus Nielsen. Here's a 2-on-1. Nielsen Clark. Leopold 2. And a shot. Stopped by Aub. And a huge stop there by the young goaltender to keep Vancouver within 1.
Well, he's going to have to make a few of those now because Vancouver's gambling offensively. And off the draw, 1 defenseman back. And Vancouver's Jovanovski just commits to the half board. That creates a 3-on-1. Give Alex Aub a ton of credit. In perfect position on that play.
Now a face-off, pulled back to Regier. A shot, blocked away by Aub. Keen after it. Donovan got there first. Lombardi has it. And Lombardi taken down by Linden. Donovan collects the puck. And the Flames are playing aggressively right now in the Vancouver zone.
They'd like to spend as much time as possible in Vancouver zone defending the lead. That's the best way to do it.
They're shooting Vancouver 11-6 now in the third period. 5 minutes left. 5 minutes to go. Third period giveaway. Aub bails out Jovanovski.
It's that poke check again and it worked again.
Now Morrison to the attack. The best Canuck forward in the series with Naslin. And Cook. Warner a chance to clear. He'll ring the boards and send Vancouver back. Couple of chances for the Flames to make it a 2-goal game. But Alex Aub comes up big again.
Jovanovski just overskates the puck. Conroy has had another whale of a game. Gets a good chance. And how about Alex Aub? He loves using that long reach of his and his poke check. It's the third time he's made big saves using his stick and then getting, this time, his left pad on it also. Faceoffs will be everything now. The latter half of this third period.
On the draw, Henrik Sedin tried to kick it to his brother Warner there. Henrik a little slow to get up as Marcus Nielsen goes back to work with speed and then lost it as he made his move on Sopel. Away goes Ruutu. He'll flip it in. Daniel Sedin after it against Ferentz. Ruutu in the corner. Hendrick to the far side. Behind the net. Daniel couldn't come up with it. And it's played by Clark to the line. Malik held the zone momentarily and then off Lombardi and out. 4:04 left here in the third period.
Sutter got away with using six defensemen pretty much exclusively until this third period, so the minutes haven't been too high for the big boys.
Now Cook, he has the lone Vancouver goal. Back to Sallow, shot! Set Kippers off the save, loose in the high slot, Nieminen. Out at center, he'll dump and chase against Sallow. Billy Nieminen, in on the forecheck, John Donovan with the puck, Boris in there. Donovan trying to hold it down there once again. Killing precious seconds. Now Morrison up with it. Outlets to Naslund. At the end of a shift, Marcus Naslund will roll it in. Now Linden back out. Along with Chubarov, Brzezinski over the boards too. Brett Warner up ahead for Iginla. Couldn't get it deep, Olin. Heats up to the Ginlett center, and it's played by Zielina down the ice. Jovanovski gives it away. Stefan Yell broke up the pass. Jovanovski takes him down along the end boards.
Just four defensemen now for Calgary.
There's Linden. A little curl inside the line. Now Rutschinski after it. He'll play it deep. Go after it against the gear. Leaves it there for Henrik Sedin. And Linden, the captain, in his third game seven, lifetime against Calgary. The other two went to overtime. Here's a shot deflecting high. Kiprasov off balance in the crease. The puck went over the net. Sokol a shot. Kiprasov gloves that away. So still some Vancouver pressure. Malik plays it along the boards. Leopold takes over.
Kiprasov, rebound control has not been great. He looks a little nervous in there at the moment, but he's making the save still.
Now Hendricks got Daniel loose, right wing. Sanderson dashing in. Pass broken up, Hendrick doesn't see it. And then a stick broken on a slash. And with 1:48 to go, a penalty is upcoming against Vancouver. Or is it? Oh, it's going against the Flames.
I think it's going to go here to Ferentz for the slash. His stick exploded on him. And once again, those sticks. And here's a little play on the hand. Enough, the stick goes. Up goes the arm. That's an even up call. However, they've been calling that the whole playoffs. And they've called it again with 1:48 to go. Only advantage that Calgary has in this situation is they can ice the puck without a whistle. And it'll be interesting to see how long it takes before all comes out of the net.
And at 48 to go. Fans on their feet.
No timeout yet for Mark Crawford. Brendan Morrison on the draw against Craig Conroy. Morrison. Very good so far in this hockey game after two periods of 25%.
Here we go.
He does here.
Craig Conroy, Brendan Morrison. And from the scrum, it's saved by the Canucks. And kept, no, not kept in at the line. Jovanovski's going to argue the call. He thought he held the zone.
And Conroy, after two periods, was 58%. I think Trevor Linden, at some point, you may see him on the ice here to take the draws. But who do you take off? Do you then put Naslund back on the point and go with four forwards? There, Naslund wins that one.
Sallow drills it in. Calgary trying to end 15 years of playoff frustration. Haven't won a series since the 89 Cup. They're 90 seconds away, but only one goal up as Cook's taken out. Naslund back. All cheating out. He's headed off. Jovanovski sends it deep. The extra attacker is Trevor Linden. Here is a chance. Morrison stopped by Kiprasov.
Big save, Kiprasov. Good rebound control that time. And now Nat Linden will be on the ice for this critical faceoff. And there's the shot. Morrison trying to be the hero again here, as he's been so much in this series. Morrison, it looks like. Now, there comes the timeout, as expected by Mark Cropper. 1:16 on the clock, and now the Canucks will regroup at the bench. See if we can watch Mark Crawford here. I don't think we're going to get a very good look at him. We might get a better look at Sutter, who looks as calm as a cucumber there, going over the faceoff alignment and the defensive responsibilities with his group. Mark Crawford maps out the offensive plan for the Vancouver Canucks. You know, since game five, Daryl Sutter and his coaching staff have talked about playing with a game seven mentality. Well, three games later, they seem to have it down pat. But can they hold on? Young group, they haven't been under this kind of pressure before.
Linden will take the draw against Yell. What a matchup this has been all series.
76 seconds left. The towels are waving in Vancouver. Linden prevails, but they're going to have to do it again. And they're going to have to add 2 seconds back onto the clock.
What is the ruling there? As Linden won the draw and then the whistle went. And we'll do it all over again.
Clock readjusted. And this time Yell gets the better of Linden. Will scrap in the corner and try and win possession back, and they do. Olin fires Kiprasov out above the blue ice to make that save. Sauer moves in. Cook in front. Jovanovski, Schober, and Regier into the net. Back up top. Olin fires. Knocked down. That hit Cook. Sallow plays it over to Naslin on the far side. Marcus Naslin directing traffic. Cook's in front. Shot, and it whistles wide around to Sallow. Back into the corner. Pass Jovanovski. Regier held up by Cook. Stays on it. Knocked down by Naslin. Half minute to go. Up top, Olin. Look at the traffic in front, and they're going to whistle it. And we're going to get penalties, I think, to both. Well, is it going to be both? I think so. Warner and Jovanovski.
It's a high sticking, at least to Jovanovski.
And it is only going to be one. He looked
and
like he signaled to Warner. Warner, without a helmet, was just the victim, apparently.
Right in the back of the neck there, three times. And it was the one to hit Warner in the back of the neck that cost Jovanovski the penalty.
Faceoff comes outside the line. Now it will be five skaters against five. 26.1 on the clock. Five skaters to four. Parents in the box. Jovanovski now in the box. Almost all my fingers accounted for.
Well, there we go. So it'll be a regular power play opportunity here with the goalie out with 26 seconds to go in the hockey game. The faceoff outside. And I'm sure they'll get it back and try and whip it around here, the boards, if in fact Morrison wins the draw.
Ginla has hit one empty net in this series. Conroy gets the draw. Ginla's got the puck, rolling it to the net and off the side of the goal. Debris on the ice and 15 seconds left. Ginla has the stick knocked out of his hand. He falls at center. Naslin dashing in. 10 seconds left. Marcus Naslin to the net. Stop. Scores! Scores! Matt Cook cashing in. 5.7 seconds left. And they're still alive. Misses an empty net, and Marcus Naslin sparks the Canucks.
And Ginla gets his stick knocked right out of his hands here. He's calling for a penalty, and then he trips on the stick, so he's in the back check without a stick. He hauls down Morrison. How about Marcus Naslin, though? He makes the great play going around, and then somehow, Matt Cook finds room in the slot. Here's Naslin cutting in.
Cook goes right past Robin Regeer. We got overtime.
1954, the time of the goal. And this Western Canadian epic won't end. Another astonishing script. It is absolutely unbelievable. Marcus Naslund, the captain, with his most determined shift of the series, creates the tying goal.
You know, Chris, to me, it's only fitting. This has been such an incredible series. It really should go into overtime, shouldn't it? And that's going to be a controversial play right there, because the officials just made a similar call on a slash, knocking a player's stick out of his hands. But it doesn't matter. The Vancouver Canucks find a way to tie this hockey game, and Ed Jovanovski can't hardly contain himself as he's all alone in the penalty box.
He might have thought it was over after his penalty. There's the Canuck reaction. Cook is third from Naslund, and Oland after Jerome Iginla's bid for a hat trick misses by that much. The series was over if Iginla hits the empty net. Instead, Brian Burke's team still has some life. Well, if you thought Game 6 was implausible, how about this? Overtime, Game 7, just like 89 and 94. Just in case, triple overtime in Game 6. And a thriller in Game 7 isn't enough. Let's go to overtime in Game 7, thanks to Matt Cook. And this building, the loudest we've heard it, it was nervous early and very quiet in the third period. What if Jerome Iginla had have sunk that 15-net puck?
Or what if he just would have continued to carry the puck into the zone, Chris, and forget about the open net? And that is a play that he'll be thinking about for quite some time if the Calgary Flames don't win this. And Alex Aull with a couple of big saves when his team was down by a goal in the third period.
Whoever the scriptwriter is, he's doing one heck of a job in this series.
And of course, Leopold allowed Naslund to walk around him. Regeer allowed Cook to go to the net. So a lot of breakdowns on that goal.
Important to note those two players in the penalty box, because Andrew Ferentz only has a dozen seconds to go. Ed Jovanovski is a minute 33, so Calgary's going to get an early power play in overtime.
Fresh ice as well.
They were able to collect themselves after the overtime loss in Game 6. Can they put it back together after coming within 6 seconds of winning Game 7? Ferentz back on the ice. And now the Flames to their fifth power play of the night. And they do have a power play goal tonight, thanks to Jerome Iginla. Jordan Leopold slowly, and now Iginla with authority over the line. Jelena in, taken down in the circle. Conroy after it there. He can't find the puck. Mike Keane, the veteran penalty killer, is able to swat it out past Leopold. 50 seconds left. And Jovanovski's penalty, Regeer. He'll send it back in. Olin pounds it off the boards. Held in by Warner in front. There's Iginla to Conroy. Conroy down. And as he tried to hook it back to the point, no one was home.
That's because Calgary was on a change. Regeer was getting off the ice to turn.
Jelena slightly headmans it to Yell over the line. 25 seconds of power play time left. Iginla still out on the ice. Back to the point, Ferentz across the ice border. Here's a shot deflecting high. Iginla off the boards. Here's Yell's shot, all big. Another huge, they score! A rebound, and it's Martin Jelena, the former Canuck, and the Calgary Flames will end the Cup curse and move on to Detroit in round two.
Stunned. They're just sitting on the bench. They can't believe it.
9 seconds left for the Jovanovski penalty, and it is a power play goal. Happy birthday, Morgan Jelena. Dad's just got a series winner. It'll be a hot time in that town tonight. Alex Auld made two highlight reel saves, and then Marty Jelena finished the series.
Oh, the Calgary Flames deserve all the credit in the world. They battled through adversity, and you talk about battling through adversity. The Vancouver Canuck organization, the Bertuzzi situation, Cloutier being hurt, and they've been doing just the same the last 15 games or so as well in the regular season, and then now throughout the playoffs. And Alex Auld with two excellent saves before Jelena here bangs it in. But it all starts with the captain, Aginla, coming off the boards. Yell keeps the puck alive. Aginla with another shot. And then Jelena barely gets the puck over Alex Auld after he made two incredible saves to keep the play alive.
Marty Jelena benched earlier in the series. Jerome Aginla, another assist. Three-point game for the captain. Jelena for Aginla and Yell at 125.
Jerome Aginla has always been a star in this league. I think we could call him a superstar now because he's starting to do it in the playoffs. He's also done it in the Olympics. He was the leader here in this game tonight, period, for the Calgary Flames.